to respond of your preoccupation. Now let me start to telling that we are going to open the second session, ordinary session for TAP on the Tuesday, 3rd of May. And Pan-African Parliament is one of the organ of AU. And like AU have a problem. And we also have a problem of finance. So we are trying now, we receive some amount every month to pay salary to some activity who is not enough. Is our budget is not, we receive small amount to make activity. Like in this session, we receive 1.5 million and $1,500,000. And this money we have to pay the salary, we have to pay the session, so it's not enough for the parliament to move. So we need some proper resource to continue to make our activity. I think we have the capacity to get our own fund for the buyers, for the partner, for the everybody who can come and help the Pan-African to move. But like I'm saying, the problem is not only the problem of PAP. It's general situation, you know. The situation, economic situation in the continent is very bad.
Okay.
And now we have this problem, and it's very, very difficult for the parliament to move. So I think we are here to try to take the hand. We need some donors, some person who is goodwill to try to help us so we can continue to work. It's not easy, it's very difficult, I know, but that is the situation for today. There are two things. The first is the problem of xenophobia, who has been discussed is the last AU summit here in Johannesburg. And I think the government of South Africa give the strong response for the problem of xenophobia. So for me, this problem get the solution now. But I don't know if tomorrow they will come again. But I think South Africa government take very strong decision according to this issue. But the big problem we have in Africa is the problem of migration. Last week I was in the AU Parliament in Brussels. We discussed with the president of European Parliament about the issue of migration. What you see is there are two kinds of migration now. One is Syrian migration. Europeans take more attention to this migration than the African migration. If you watch the TV last few weeks, you see the Pope Francis who come with 12 people from Syria and bring them to Vatican. Oh. The situation is what? The African migration is near Vatican. This kind of situation, we don't have the opportunity, African don't have the opportunity to be, to get this change to be brought in Vatican with us. So I think that the AU have to pay attention, have to take this problem like another problem in Africa, problem of terrorism and problem of the economic. So the problem of migration is very important for AU to deal with this situation. I think the solution of the migration, the youth migration, is individual country have to take, have to pay attention for the youth. Have to try to make, but the problem is what? What is the real problem? The problem is that Africa is not industrialized. So you cannot get more job here in the continent. And like you are saying, the youth try to go because they think that there you can get better life. But it's not true. It's very difficult in Europe. Now Europe get economic situation in Europe is very bad. But the first thing, if Africa want to resolve this problem, is to change the way they are dealing now. So we have, is not every time, we cannot stop to send our raw material in Europe. We have to transform our raw material here so we can get more employers, more. But if we cannot, it will be the same. This movement cannot stop. So I think we have to arrange the political issue, the governance, and so on. So I think if this thing with EU try to deal, try to ameliorate, to give the good condition for the youth, I think is the migration cannot stop. So we need this, we need that every country must arrange the situation so we can give the opportunity for the young people to work here in Africa. It's better to work here than going to Europe. And you know, when you cross the Mediterranean, some of them died. Many people of Africa, nobody can tell you, you know the number. You say 500, maybe it's 2,000. So nobody know about how many persons die in Mediterranean to try to cross to go to Europe. This is the first achievement, the first major achievement for PAP, integration.
Okay.
You know, now you cannot move in Africa to one country to another. You have a problem of it. It's very difficult now to move to one country to another, especially if you come in the central is some country. The Western country is good now. The Western country, ECOWAS country is good. But if you go in the central region, it's very difficult to move to Cameroon, to Equatorial Guinea. So that is a big challenge. Or if you see in terms of the population, Equatorial Guinea is a small country, but we can get and go, we can move inside the country. It's very easy for us if we are going to move each country further. But it's very difficult now to do that. So I think the first thing is the Pan-Africanism. Is the to give the full legislative power to PAP so we can take the decision, you can get the law who can try to bring all the African country, very all the people of Africa to be united. But it's not easy because you know, some country now, according to the terrorism, according to some situation, say no. You are going to lock its boundary. It's very difficult to move. Like I'm saying, it's very difficult to move to Africa in this period, according to this. But the good situation to try to minimize the effect of migration, European migration, is to be a free movement people inside the continent and the free trade. In Africa, it will be a very good change for Africa people. Don't think to go to the West. What AU did for his own member state to sign and ratify the protocol, that is a big challenge. Because now we are trying, like MPs, to make to lobbying. It's not our. It's not we sign. It's not we adopted. It's the head of state. What is the problem now? What they don't want to sign? That is the problem of Africa. It's not only the legal instrument of PAP. It's all the legal instrument of AU. They sign, after they agree something, but after that we have a difficulty to ratify. So I think the first work has made to bring this protocol to ratify is AU himself have to work very, very hard. But now I think there are some difficulty to bring this ratification. But for us, we are trying to push. But like your colleague said, we have a problem of finance. Moving to one country to another to go and lobbying, you have to pay the travel. You have to eat. You have to. So I think we have two major problems. And to resolve this problem is AU who have the solution. Because while we are the head of state come to the conference, this is the good opportunity to say no, we have adopted the protocol of PAP. What is the problem? Why you don't want to sign? But every assembly, every conference of AU, I go there to try to introduce, to try to resume the situation of the ratification. They are moving like the old lorry, very old lorry. So but we are trying to push. According to the session, the issue we are going to deal to many issues. The first one is the human right, especially for the woman. We're going to discuss. Then we have the EU budget. We're going to discuss about the EU budget and some another issue, the problem of security. We're going to that. But the real problem for me is to give the full legislative power to PP. And this, we need you, like member of the press, to lobby. We need the civil society. We need everybody to bring his support. Because if you look, the difference of the Pan-African Parliament and the European Parliament, is what is the difference? The difference is that Pan-African Parliament is very, very big parliament in terms of population. But EU is very big in terms of finance and in terms of the decision. But here we have maybe 1 billion, 1.2. And if you go to EU, it's 500 million people. But the parliament is very strong there. So we need, it's not only for us, it's for the interests of Africa. We have many subjects we can deal. Many, many. You have the climate change, you have the terrorism, you have the school. So this problem is the common problem in the whole continent. How we can build one strategy to deal for all these issues. But now it's very difficult for us because we are still making the recommendation only. If tomorrow we get a full legislative, I think we can move, try to unite, to bring all the continent to united. So what is why we are trying to do? The meeting for today, you know, ambassador is representing the state member. So we are always, when we meet them, we can bring some experience to our work. We can exchange some issues, and then we build one strategic. And is also is also the man we can send the information to the country. So we meet the ambassador this morning to tell them that the problem of ratification is a big challenge. Most of the country of EU don't want to ratify. So this information will be transferred to the city capital for each ambassador to know that Pan-African have a problem of ratification. And then we discuss about the president is attending for the session. It's very important because Pan-African Parliament is the parliament of all the country in Africa. So if you have a problem here, you have to inform the ambassador here in South Africa, who can in particular extend the information to the city capital. So it's very important to meet before the session the ambassador who is here in South Africa.